Around 2,500 years ago, there was a philosopher by the name of Zeno living in the once Greek, now Italian city then known as Elea. He is best known for proposing a series of paradoxes. The one which we will consider today is commonly called Zeno's arrow paradox. Zeno proposes that an arrow in flight never moves. This seems, of course, totally insane. However, it is rooted in perhaps reasonable assumptions. First, Zeno assumes that we can divide time into an infinite number of durationless points. He then assumes that the arrow has two options regarding its motion. First, to move to where it is, and second, to move to where it is not. As the arrow is already where it is, it cannot move there, but as no time elapses between successive points in time, it cannot move to where it is not. Assuming that time does in fact divide into infinitely many points, this would appear to make all motion impossible. At first glance, this problem would seem to have little bearing on modern science, and yet one of the most quizzical quantum mechanical effects is named for it. Welcome to the quantum Zeno effect. Most people have at least some idea that the quantum world isn't quite what we see around us. Often they'll have heard of Schrödinger's famous thought experiment involving an unfortunate cat in a box with a vial of poison released when a radioactive atom decays. The general idea is that the cat has a chance of being both dead and alive until the box is opened and the state of the cat can be determined. This somewhat counterintuitive result hints at the notion that a quantum measurement can impact the state of the system. As it would appear that physicists have a deep loathing for cats, it seems only fitting to keep a feline for our next experiment. Imagine a cat, curled up in the sun, looking a bit dozy. You're not sure if he's asleep, so you give him a poke. If the cat is asleep, poking him has no effect. Cats are very deep sleepers. But if the cat is awake, poking him will make him agitated and fully awake. In this situation, the cat has two states, awake and asleep, and it can only be in one of these two states. However, left undisturbed, the chances of finding the cat asleep increase with time. It is also very easy to see that if you frequently poke the cat, it would never fall asleep, hence remaining in the awake state until it gets fed up and walks away. This two-state approach is very different to how a standard classical system works. For example, the temperature of water in a kettle is a continuous variable, and so measuring it doesn't cause the water to instantaneously freeze or boil, it just measures it. In the quantum Zeno effect, rather than a dozy cat, we have a collection of atoms. These atoms can exist in one of two states. At the start of the experiment, all of the atoms are in state 1, but as time goes by, the probability of any atom transitioning to state 2 increases. To measure the state of this system, photons could be fired into the atoms. If state 1 absorbs the photons, but state 2 does not, then the proportion of atoms in each state can be calculated by measuring the amount of light transmitted. The quantum Zeno effect would seem to suggest that by repeatedly measuring the atoms in this system, the rate at which they transition to state 2 would be decreased with increasing frequency of measurement. Of course, this is physics, and so we need evidence. So in 1990, Wayne et al. At the US National Institute of Standards and Technology, NIST, performed an experiment using beryllium ions, and found that the effect did indeed increase with frequency of measurement. Using the quantum Zeno effect, it's possible to do some very useful things. It has major applications in quantum interrogation, which allows the measurement of systems without ever disturbing them. This is handy if you have a system which is so highly unstable that it couldn't be maintained under measurement. This technique has even been used to produce an image of an object without the object ever being hit by a photon. I wonder what Zeno would have to say about that.